This is a video about spans and linear combinations. The span of a set of vectors is the set of all possible linear combinations of those vectors. So really, these two questions are very closely related. We want to know, is a particular vector expressible as a linear combination of v1, v2, v3? And if so, find that expression of the vector A as a linear combination of vectors v1, v2, and v3. To do this, we're going to use an augmented matrix. To answer the first question, we're going to get it into row echelon form, which will tell us if it is expressible as a linear combination of v1, v2, and v3. Then we will have to go to reduced row echelon form to actually find that expression of A in terms of v1, v2, and v3. Let's get started. First of all, let's unpack this definition of span and have a good look at it.
The span of v1, v2, and v3 is the set of all vectors, x, in this case from R3, because v1, v2, and v3 are from R3, such that x is equal to lambda 1, v1, plus lambda 2, v2, plus lambda 3, v3, 4, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, elements of R, just real numbers.
That is to say, the span of these three vectors is the set of all vectors which are linear combinations of the vectors v1, v2, and v3. So, if we want to know if A is in this span, what we're really asking is, can you represent A as a linear combination of these vectors? That's what the first part of this question is about. For the second part, you're actually asked to find those lambdas. Good. Let us proceed. Can you write a vector as a linear combination of the other vectors? Well, this is the kind of thing that we've already done in Math 1A, where we solve this system of linear equations using an augmented matrix.
So we'll solve it with the augmented matrix, whose first column is V1, second column is negative 1, negative 2, 1, V2, third column is 3, 3, negative 1, and in the augmented column we have the vector A. Good.
Now we are in a position where everyone is comfortable. There is only one thing to do with a matrix like this, and that's get it into row echelon form. I'll assume that you already know how to get this into row echelon form, so I'll skip all the row reduction and just say in row echelon form, we have by row reduction the matrix 1, negative 2, 3, 4, 11, 0, 1, negative 1, negative 4, 0, 0, 1, 1. Row reduction will take you there. Good. This is a very special matrix. This is a row echelon form matrix. We'll just pause for a moment to appreciate that. The leading terms are the leftmost non-zero terms in each row. So here's a leading term. Here's another leading term. And here's another leading term. Each of these leading terms are below and to the right, each of these leading terms are above and to the right of the next lower down leading term, so they form this nice descending staircase, and if I have rows of zeros there at the bottom. Good. Row echelon form. this row echelon form tells me that there are solutions, unique solutions in fact, to this equation. So you can express A as a linear combination of V1, V2, and V3. We don't yet know what those lambdas are, but we know they exist. Thank you very much, row echelon form. So we can, at this point, say that, yes, A is in the span.
So we might say, since row echelon form matrix has solutions, then A is in the span of V1, V2, and V3.
For the second part of this question, we're asked to explicitly express A as a linear combination of the vectors V1, V2, and V3. That is to say, solve this equation. Our tool for solving equations like this is to use an augmented matrix. And from the previous question, we're almost there. We've taken at this, represented it as an augmented matrix, and we've already gotten to row echelon form. Now you can unpack the solutions directly from this, or you can go to reduced row echelon form. I prefer to go to reduced row echelon form because this matrix will manage all your coefficients for you. So you perform a few more row operations and you get this in reduced row echelon form. I will again skip over the elementary row operations. This is just 1, 0, 0, bar, let's see, 2, 0, 1, 0, negative 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. Excellent. And this allows you to unpack the coefficients directly. So from row 3, we know that lambda 3 is equal to 1. Literally, this final row says 0 times lambda 1 plus 0 times lambda 2 plus lambda 1 times lambda 3, so this is just lambda 3, is equal to 1. Similarly, from row 2, we know that 0 lambda 1 plus 1 lambda 2 plus 0 lambda 3, so this is just lambda 2, is equal to 9, is equal to minus 3.
Lambda 2 is equal to minus 3, and from row 1 we know that lambda 1 is equal to 2.
Excellent. We have now solved this equation and obtained lambda 1, lambda 2, and lambda 3.
Hence, let's see, 2 times V1 is lambda 1 is 2. Minus 3v2 plus v3 is supposed to be equal to A.
And we've done a lot of work to get here, so it might be worthwhile just checking this.
Or 2 times v1, so that's... So 2v1 is 4, 2, 8. Minus 3 times v2, so that's minus... plus minus 3... plus 3, plus 6, and minus 3, plus 3, 3, minus 1, and we can just add these up, so that's 4, plus 3 is 10, 2, plus 6, plus 3 is 11, and 8, minus 4 is 4. Excellent.
Truly, A can be represented as this explicit linear combination of V1, V2, and V3.